72nd seed
for the game, Dave. First of all, for South Carolina, you've got to establish the tempo. You can't go three and out to start this football game. That gives Vandy life. And if you're Vandy, you've got to believe that you can win. You've got to have success early. Last year, they had success late. They need to start off, drive the football the length of the field, and get ready to go.
And we are just moments away from getting ready to go, Big Dave. And there is Lou Holtz, who has taken over the reins of the offense at South Carolina. We really don't know what to expect. We'll see that play out here in a couple of minutes. And there is Bobby Johnson, who just yesterday received a contract extension. He already had 4 years remaining on a current contract, but let's just say that he will be here for a long, long time, at least through the rest of this decade. So that's good news for Vanderbilt fans. Bobby Johnson with a contract extension. Obtain Aronimich to kick it off for the Vanderbilt Commodores. Vandy won the toss. They deferred, and South Carolina elects to receive. Good kickoff. Deep in the end zone, and Williamson will take a knee, and South Carolina will take over at the 20. Well, let's check in with Dave Rowe, the third member of our team. He's down on the sidelines. Buzz?
All right, Dave, good talking to you again this year. Bobby Johnson is talking a lot about expectations. He's not trying to downplay him. 20-plus starters back. Vandy's trying to get in a bowl game for the first time in 20 years. Lou Holtz, he's trying to change the mindset. Look at the shirts the Gamecocks are wearing. Shut up and hit somebody. You know what? I'm going to do that because Dave Rowe might take somebody up on that offer.
Exactly. You might hit me after I called you Dave Rowe. Dave Baker, Buzz. I'm so excited. It's opening day. 2004. Under center, Dondrell Pinkins for South Carolina. They'll line up in the I formation. Handoff off the left side to Gonzi Gray. And Gonzi close to a first down. Gonzi Gray will actually get the start today. Many people thought Demetrius Summers and Corey Boyd were. Here is our Chevy starting lineups. And there is Gonzi Gray making his first career start. Gonzi, the senior out of Waldorf, Maryland, who had a great preseason camp. Up front, John Strickland, a Remington Trophy watch list member. He is an outstanding offensive line. This is a good starting group for South Carolina. And there is Dondrell Pinkins, who last year might have tried to do a little too much to get this South Carolina team going and lost a little bit of confidence. But they're gaining some here. The end around in front of the South Carolina bench to Matthew Thomas to pick up a Gamecock first down, a gain of 16. Vanderbilt's defense, Jovan Hay. If you follow SEC football, you heard about him last year, 8.5 sacks, third in the league, but that front four, pretty good. The linebacking core all return. As a matter of fact, just about this whole team does, with 21 starters coming back. Moses Asimaji, a guy to keep an eye on. Kelechi Ohanaja in that secondary. 10 tackles in Columbia. A little play action. Pinkins will now throw. Dondrell rolling near side. Fires. Pass knocked out of there by Dominique Morris, the cornerback. It was intended for Matthew Thomas.
And, Dave, that's a surprise to me. You come out, you've run the football. You're South Carolina. You've run the football to almost midfield. Why abandon that? I know it's play action. It looks like a run, but, hey, they started off running the ball. Gonzi Gray ran it, picked up first downs. Just keep on running the football. Don't change. That's what takes momentum away from Vanderbilt.
And Demetrius Summers checks into the game. The very talented tailback had some issues over the summer and had to sit out the first series, and some movement up front. Looks like Chris White, the left guard, might have popped up on that South Carolina offensive line.
Before the snap, dead ball. False start. Offense number 60, 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
And that is our referee today, Jeff Robertson. Our all-SEC officiating crew, of course.
Now, if you're Vanderbilt, that's a big play. Brings you up second down, 15 yards. It changes the complexion. Now you're going to have to run past the football. Now you can get pressure on the quarterback. Got to come after him.
The Gamecocks will go into a four-receiver set. Pinkins in the shotgun. Otis Washington had a hustle off the field. They'll swing it out to the far side. Here's Summers trying to create some opportunity. Couldn't do it. A flag comes down. Only gained about a yard, if that. Kevin Joyce, the sophomore. And another flag also deep in that Vanderbilt secondary. We'll sort out these calls.
I saw Bill Alford get up really late. He got chopped down, and he was late getting up. Number 7, the deep cornerback. And he's pointing a finger out there. It was a screen pass out to the flat. You can't go down and cut downfield. Not until the pass is thrown.
There are two fouls on the play. Personal foul, face mask on the defense. That penalty is 15 yards and an automatic first down. After the play, personal foul on the offense. That penalty is 15 yards. It will be first down and 10.
So I think Vanderbilt lost that war,
yes,
giving up the first down. They had South Carolina in a third and 13 situation coming up. But the face mask penalty will award South Carolina that first down. By the way, these were the two fewest penalized teams in the Southeastern Conference a year ago. South Carolina only averaged about 45 yards per game, while Vanderbilt was tops 39 yards per game.
And there's Skip Holtz right there, the offensive. Well, I guess he's offensive coordinator. Well, he's not actually offensive coordinator because Lou Holtz is.
Assistant head coach.
Assistant head coach.
And quarterback's coach. And
right.
He has plenty of input still in the play calling, but the bottom line rests with Lou Holtz on that sidelines in terms of what to call. And we'll see what he does here. Three wide receiver set on first down and 10 from the Gamecock 41. Handoff goes to Summers, breaks a couple of tackles. But three or four Commodores to finally bring him down. Dominic Morris led the charge. And that'll be a gain of four, maybe five on the play.
Well, that's tough 4 or 5 yards. And the reason that it's tough is because Summers just keeps, watch his legs. This is what makes great running backs. You run through tackle. Look at that. The legs never stop. Just keep on churning. Pull out of that jersey. You're not going to bring him down one person. You hold on until you get a lot of people there.
Summers will head back to that sideline. You see what Summers did a year ago, averaged 5.1 yards per carry. Ran into a little bit of a slump late in the season as a true freshman. Dacus Terman checks in, but Pinkins will keep it. Get close to that midfield stripe. Well, Dave, I asked in our meetings with Coach Holtz earlier this week, I asked him, I said, how important is it for you to come out and establish a lengthy drive, put some points on the board after the way the team finished a year ago, in particular the game against Clemson, which he said was his most embarrassing moment as a head coach. And he kind of jumped at me and said, it's not about the first drive or the first quarter. It's a 60-minute game, but I got to think, you know, if they can pick up a first down here and get another set of plays, he's got to be happy with the way his offense came out.
Dave, when he jumped on you, I thought to myself, that means how important it is.
Here's Pinkins, and he will get that first down, so a fresh set of downs coming up for the Gamecocks. Ohanaja makes the tackle. Give Pinkins 4 on the carry.
Boy, and Pinkins is an interesting quarterback. This is run all the way. Come down the line, read it. You see, you got your amount of yardage you have to get for that first down. All you do is scramble forward. But Pinkins is much better. He's not that drop-back pure passer looking downfield. Big guys up front driving off the ball. But Pinkins is not that drop-back pure passer. He's more of a play action.
Well, how much will that play, this graphic we're showing you in terms of when this game unfolds? 310 versus 285.
It's big. Let me tell you something. I played this game a long time. 25 pounds per man. That's huge.
Dacus Terman, the junior out of Washington, Georgia.
Now, this is exactly what I would do if I was South Carolina. I wouldn't put the ball in Pinkins' hand to throw. I'd just come right down there, just blow him off the line, try to control the line of scrimmage. Look at this, good downfield block right there. Good pick up there. Look downfield. You get that burst when you get through there.
Well, there is no question that Bobby Johnson's defense will have their hands full with the offensive line of South Carolina. It's just depth is the concern for the Gamecocks. Here's Pinkins around the left side. He gets some good blocks and picks up a Gamecock first down. He's inside the 25, down to the 23-yard line. And South Carolina just chugging here on the opening drive.
Well, 32 is Dacus Terman. He is going to get a great block. Right in there. You saw it to the left of your screen. He gets a great block downfield. That's what made his pop at the outside and go.
Let's check in with Buzz.
Dave, you may be seeing the real influence of Lou Holtz on this offense. This is much more a Lou Holtz kind of game, keeping it on the ground. South Carolina's also changed the way they're calling plays. Remember last year, Skip Holtz told us they had to change the signals because so many guys were in the conference. A player actually brings that play in now, and so far it's been successful.
Ninth play of this drive. Only one pass to this point, and they'll keep it on the ground again. Gonzi Gray inside the 20, down to possibly the 18-yard line. That'll bring up a second down. Second down, maybe five. And a good time to maybe try something here on second down and relatively short.
Well, Gonzi Gray is an interesting story. A senior, he had a great surprise in the spring ball. He played really, really well. He's got good vision, makes nice cutbacks. That was a good example of it on that last drive.
Two tight ends in the game, single setback. Here's Gonzi Gray. He gets the handoff. Gray down to the 10-yard line, and that'll be enough for another South Carolina first down. Andrew Pace makes the tackle.
Interesting, Dave, on that run. Watch Gray. He runs under control, and when he sees the hole, watch right there, he sees the hole. You see him just sprint to get to the outside now, put the head down. And again, cut off Javon Hay. That's a good job by the backside tight end. Cutting him off there. That's Andy Boyd, number 80.
First down and 10. Out of the shotgun. Pinkins. A little quarterback draw down to the 5-yard line. The chains are actually up, so there is a chance. There's only about 3 inches between the first down marker and the goal line, so there is a possibility for a first down, but I think South Carolina would just as soon get it right in the end zone. And Dave, how about this drive?
Fantastic.
Already?
Oh, unbelievable. Running the football, controlling the line of scrimmage. As you said, Lou Holtz football, drive it down there. They're using that little slip block. They're following Alston, number 72, on that little tackle guard around. And Pinkins has made it work.
Here's Summers with the handoff. Cuts it back down to the one. And they'll mark him just shy of the goal line. Otis Washington made the final hit.
Where'd the knee go down? Watch the knee. Right in there. See it now. There he stretches out. That's an excellent call by the official coming in from the side.
It's hard to believe he didn't pick up a first down. It was right on the goal line. So we'll see if they can get a fresh set from the 6-inch line. Lou Holtz talking to Dontrell Pinkins, and I can't imagine a better scenario for Lou Holtz in terms of getting that confidence of his football team together.
Well, this is exactly what we talked about in keys to the game. South Carolina needed to come out, set the tempo of the game. Don't go three and out and give life to Vanderbilt. They're trying to set that tempo, just get a dominance in this game. They're doing it with their offensive line up front.
And it's been nothing fancy.
Nah, it's my kind of football. Big man on big man.
Third down and very short for the first down. Third down and just a little bit longer for six. Pinkins, quarterback keeper. We will wait for the signal.
Boy.
Touchdown, South Carolina. Man, what an impressive drive.
Well, if you were to quote Lou Holtz, you'd say, we're going back to the basics. The basics is just drive them off. Push, get penetration, get that line of scrimmage. And South Carolina established, you talk about establishing tempo, that established tempo on that drive.
Josh Brown in to attempt the extra point. Joey Bowers will do the holding. Ike Crowfoot will snap it. And it is good. A lengthy ball control drive results in a touchdown for the Gamecocks. Back after this. South Carolina leading 7-0 here in the first quarter of the first SEC game of 2004. Vanderbilt's defense on the field for quite a while. Now the offense will have to come back and try to respond. Joey Bowers will kick off for South Carolina. Quanne Doster, a potentially very dangerous return man, stands alone at the goal line. End-over-end wobbly kick, and Doster will take it at the 8. Quanay sees a little bit of a hole, bounces around like a pinball out to the 30, so good field position for Vanderbilt to start their opening drive. And speaking of opening drives, our Safe Auto Insurance successful drive was the last one by South Carolina, and it was impressive. 13 plays, 88 yards, ate up nearly 6 minutes, capped off by the Pinkins' one-yard run. They had 7 first downs, 6 by rushing in that drive. That successful drive means another $500 to the SEC's Education Initiative, courtesy of Safe Auto Insurance Company. Call 1-800-SAFE-AUTO, and you too can be a successful driver. And now it's Vanderbilt's turn, and their experienced quarterback, Jay Cutler, to lead the charge. The junior out of Santa Claus, Indiana, will throw on first down. As his man, Norval McKenzie, out of the backfield. And our Chevy starting lineup for Vanderbilt, Norval McKenzie gets the start. He is a tackle-to-tackle runner, but really showed that he has some potential to get outside. Up front, Justin Geisinger. This guy is a mammoth. They've actually had to tone down his weightlifting. He was getting too strong, but he also has good footwork. We'll let Dave talk about that a little bit later as the game goes on. But Jay Cutler's the man who makes this offense go. 57% completion percentage a year ago. Best in 13 years here at Vanderbilt. McKenzie dropped for no gain by Fred Bennett, the sophomore cornerback.
When you wonder what's the cornerback doing up there, but watch him. Look how quick he gets in the backfield. Bam, when you come right across that football like that, good reaction.
And looks like a sideline warning coming. And now a flag has been thrown right in front of that South Carolina bench.
Gosh, I know they give
first
you...
First sideline warning to South Carolina. First warning.
And we'll take a look at that South Carolina defense. And they have two great ends, I think. Two of the better pair of defensive ends in the league. Marcus Lawrence, Ricardo Hurley, Rodriguez Wilson will see some depth there this year. These guys are healthy. In the secondary, the big question mark. Fred Bennett and Coach Simpson, a couple of newcomers in that secondary. We'll see if Vanderbilt wants to test them early. Oh, South Carolina read that little shovel pass like they knew it was coming. McKenzie was popped by Darryl Shropshire. A loss of 4.
Well, when you get penetration in the backfield, look at Shropshire. He's right in the backfield. He almost made the catch. Again, penetration. That's what you want on your defensive line. Nowhere to go. Look how far he is in the backfield. 3 yards in the backfield. That's not going to work.
So now Vanderbilt will have to punt. Opteen Ramanesh to kick it away. Noah Whiteside stands at the 20-yard line. He'll take it at the 19. Sees the seam. Has a big hole. Whiteside. Brought down by Ramanesh at the 38-yard line.
Dave, that's an incredible run back, but that may be the best open field tackle I've ever seen by a punter. Again, watch him come through here. That's a big, huge seam. Just tries to dodge. Now look right there. You see number 75? That's the Ramanesh. He just breaks down. Now watch him right in here. Ramanesh is going to come up. Look right here. Now, there's the seam. Right there. You got two blockers there. This is going to be the tackler. But watch the Ramanesh right there. Break down. Don't let him fake you out. Just try to slow him down. He did a great job.
There's some play action. Pinkins to throw. Goes up top. Has his man at the 5. Intended for Troy Williamson. A catch he probably should have made. It was a little bit high. And an injured Vandy player, Bill Alfer, who's already been dinged up once today. And
now this is on the tail end of play. Watch Alfer come up high. I wonder if he just comes down awkward. Yeah, it looks like he just came down awkward, maybe on that ankle.
Well, that would have been a tough catch.
See how he comes right down there? Again, slaps that leg down.
Well, he's holding that left arm. We'll get an update when we come back after a word from your local stations. Under his own power, looked like it was a left shoulder perhaps and left elbow area, but he seems like he might be able to check back in. Second down and 10 now for the Gamecocks. Higgins to throw again. Wide open over the middle is Troy Williamson. Williamson inside the 20, down to the 17. That'll be a Gamecock first down. Galecio Hanaja makes the tackle from his safety spot after the gain of 22 yards.
Well, I talked about Pinkins not being a great dropback pure passer, but good pocket presence right there. Wait for it to open, look across the middle, and find the seam. Again, a little dart pattern inside. Look at this, just come back inside. Huge big hole inside there. When that offensive line gives you time to sit back there, you can wait for that second break, and that's what Pinkins did.
On first and 10. Handoff goes to Corey Boyd, sophomore out of Orange, New Jersey. Gets a few on the carry, give him three.
And Dave, what I see is South Carolina's controlling the line of scrimmage. They're driving them off at least a yard to 2 yards and allowing the back to run up there and make that little tiny wiggle. There was no big hole that time, but Boyd still picks up 3-4 yards.
This offensive line for South Carolina has been very impressive to this point. Pinkins rolls left, gets another couple of good blocks. He gets inside the 10, close to the first down marker. Andrew Pace knocks him out of bounds. On that first drive that scored a touchdown, Dave, Dondrell Pinkins had 5 carries for 29 yards and picked up the touchdown.
Well, we talked about how dangerous it is. Not a pure passer. Not going to sit back there, Eli Manning type. But he does nice play action. He's got a great sense. I think that if he couldn't make it as a quarterback in the NFL, maybe he'll be a wide receiver because he's got that kind of speed. But that's a long way off for him right now.
We will see number 2 quarterback, Chevelle Newton, at some point today for South Carolina. Here's the handoff. Goes to Dacus Terman. Not much happening on that play. Let's check in with Buzz down on the sidelines.
Dave, Lou Holtz brought in one of his great Notre Dame teams here in 1996. They won in a very close game. But as you look at this South Carolina offense right now with Holtz again calling the plays, you can't help but notice the similarities between the way he's using Dondrell Pinkins and the way he used Tony Rice at Notre Dame. I think the crafty coach has gone back in the playbook, and he certainly found something that's worked here early on.
And Buzz, you know, he basically told us that he just didn't have the players to run the spread offense a year ago, and he was going to do what he thought his players could do best, and obviously it's working to this point. Pinkins, little keeper, gets it down inside the 3. We'll see if they'll mark it. They'll mark it right about the 3-yard line. Osimichi on the stop.
Well, a huge play for Vanderbilt would be if they were able to stop him here. You can't let this game get out of control. That's what they did last year. Let the game get out of control. It was, what, 28-3 before Vandy came back. Got to make a stop here if you're Vanderbilt. Got to get some emotion. Bobby Johnson knows that.
Third and goal. Ball rest at the 3-yard line. Pinkins keeps it. He is stopped short. They'll mark it inside the 1. Ohanaja makes the tackle for Vanderbilt, but now it'll be 4th down and goal. And the way this offensive line has worked, Dave, I don't think there's any question, but you got to go for this.
Absolutely. Lou Holtz is he's the master of the running game. Get down there, drive him off. If you don't score, you give the ball to Vandy on the 1-yard line. It's early. You've got your team controlling the line of scrimmage.
And this is where the fact that South Carolina doesn't have a true fullback might hurt him, but Pinkins is 250 pounds at quarterback. He'll lob it up in the air, looking for his tight end, Ryan Brownlee. Touchdown, South Carolina.
That may be the ugliest pass I have ever seen in my 30 years of football. I've never seen a pass like that. He was going to play action into the line, try to get everybody up, and then he was just going to dump it over top right in here. Look at the pass. No spiral. It almost looked like a basketball shot. Look at this. Throw it up high. Good concentration looking the football in. Boy, and Vanderbilt, they have got to do something. They've got to get in there and stop. But for South Carolina, they're saying, hey, it's starting off just like last year.
Okay. Point after is up and good by Josh Brown. Two possessions, two touchdowns. If you're a Gamecock fan, you couldn't ask for more. 14-0, South Carolina. First quarter action from Nashville. Our SEC opener, Dave Neal, Dave Rowe, Dave Baker. Glad you could join us here on Jefferson Pilot Sports. Quan A. Doster back to return the kick of Joey Bowers. High end-over-end kick, not very deep at the 10-yard line. Doster starts his trek the other way. Brought down at the 28-yard line. Nice high kick, giving his team an opportunity to cover that. Well, Dave, let's go back to that touchdown. Why was this successful?
Well, first of all, offensive line controlling a little bit of play action down the line here. You run up into here. Everybody is holding in here. Then you sneak your tight end, Brownlee, off the line of scrimmage. Again, little play action fake. Now, just top the ball up there. Look at the good concentration by Brownlee. Not a pretty pass. Not a pretty completion. But you see those arms go up for 7 points. That's beautiful if you're a South Carolina fan.
Here's the handoff to Orval McKenzie, and he got maybe a half a yard before it was popped by linebacker Ricardo Hurley.
Dave, if you're in that Vanderbilt huddle right now, what's going to happen is you get real anxious. Nothing seems to work. The line of scrimmage, South Carolina's getting good penetration. You see the running back trying to make cuts in the backfield, so you get a little impatient. Now you got to make something happen. See if Cutler doesn't try to go downfield a little bit more. Challenge that secondary. That's the youngest part. That's the most vulnerable part of South Carolina's defense.
Cutler under center on second down and a long 10. Fires over the middle, nearly picked off. Looking for his tight end, Dustin Dunning. Pass was nearly picked off by Coach Simpson, the freshman out of Rock Hill, South Carolina.
Boy, this is what happens when your tight end goes the wrong way. He's supposed to do a curl. See, it goes over top of his head right there. It was overstretched, but again, he's got to come back. He's got to stretch for that football. Can't let it go through there clear. A little bit of a curl action.
Third down and 10.
Big down.
Cutler lost it up. Pass ball's incomplete. No flags and intended for Marlon Wright. Vanderbilt will have to punt it again. This South Carolina defense is swarming all over the football field.
Hey, Lou Holtz told us that they came in the best shape that they came in preseason. He said this is one of the teams that I just couldn't believe how well they came in. And they are proving it. They're playing hard football up there. They've got a little bit of depth. They are flat out coming after Vandy.
Flag down, Whiteside to return the punt. Has some room, dancing around. Gets it out to the 39-yard line, but a flag down back at the line of scrimmage. Well, South Carolina's defense getting tested. We'll see how much depth they really have today. They've been on the football field almost the entire first quarter.
Not enough players on the line of scrimmage on the kicking team. Penalty is declined. First down.
Well, 2 years in a row, the Gamecocks have missed out on a ball, but Lou Holtz told us earlier he's ready for season number 33.
I've never been more enthusiastic, never spent more time on football. I haven't enjoyed it this much in many, many years because of the challenge, because of the opportunity, and because of the fact that I do want to see some changes. Because when you talk about Carolina, you talk about one thing. Fans. Our fans deserve better.
And, you know, I think he's referring to maybe that final stretch last year, culminating with the loss to Clemson, where they just got annihilated. And he took it really upon himself to make some changes. Five new coaches. He makes himself the offensive coordinator. And so far, the results look pretty good. Here's Demetrius Summers around the left side. Ohanaja runs him out of bounds. Gain of 5 on the play.
I think that's the key. That's going to be the key to this football game, too, is a run like that. It's not going anywhere, and he picks up 5 yards on it. You got to stop him. You got to bring up that second down and 7. Vanderbilt has got to try something a little bit different. They've got to come with a little bit of blitz action, run blitz action where you can stop, get people in the gaps, get your linemen slanting to the football, but they've got to get in the backfield of South Carolina.
Go back to that opening drive when South Carolina was facing third and very long, but Vanderbilt had a face mask penalty that provided an automatic first down. Here's Summers. Another huge hole. Summers. Demetrius Summers inside the 25. Dragged down by Dominic Morris. Another huge gain for the Gamecocks. A gain of 32.
A huge hole. It's a cutback hole. The play is designed to go out here. It doesn't. It cuts back inside and right in here. Look at this. Late penetration. Good block down here. Look at the size of that hole that he's got. He makes a good cut back inside. Picks up two or three big blocks. This is huge. He's just, you're not going to arm tackle that young man.
First down and 10. Bruce Howard, defensive coordinator, looking on. Gets to the outside, doesn't get much, stopped at the 20-yard line. Corey Boyd dragged down by three or four gold jerseys, the first of which was Otis Washington. Let's go down to Dave Baker with our Altel sideline connection.
Dave, you talked about the changes Lou Holtz made. He also sent a message, and Demetrius Summers was one of those guys that got that message. He was one of seven players who was required to work out on their own because they weren't going to summer school like they should. Then to get back in good graces, listen to this physical fitness thing they had to pass. It took him three tries to run 30 40-yard dashes and an average of 4.8 per time. He's running well today.
I'd say so. High pass, but caught. Far side by Corey Boyd, picks up the first down at around the 11-yard line. Andrew Pace drags him down, a gain of 9 for South Carolina. Here's our Aaron scoreboard. Oklahoma ranks second in the country out on top of it. Michigan expected to win that Big Ten possibly. Ohio State right in the mix as well. Iowa over Kent State. California, top 15 appearance to start the year. Virginia over Temple, Wisconsin over Central Florida, 10-3. A couple of tight ends on first and 10. Pinkins dragged down. Aaron Carter, the senior out of Wallingford, Pennsylvania, makes the tackle for Vanderbilt. One of the first times we actually saw that defensive line make some penetration for Vanderbilt.
I was just thinking it's the first time that they stopped him for less than 4 or 5 yards on that first down play. Now, second down, 7, 8, 9 yards. That's what you want. You don't want it on your own 10-yard line, but now you can play defense. Again, penetration. Get off the ball. Get in the backfield. Disrupt something.
Couple of tight ends in the game. Michael Flint out wide. Noah Whiteside in the slot. With the handoff. We'll take it inside the 8-yard line. Dacus Terman on the carry. Kevin Joyce on the tackle.
Javon Hay has just been non-existent today. Look at this. Double team here. Good cross outside in there. Make him go around the pressure. You never go around the backside of a block. Hay's working hard, but you've got to go across the face. Don't go around the block. He's a great football player. He just didn't get off to a good start in this game. And they're running away from him, Dave.
Third down. And 6 to go. First down markers right about the 1-yard line.
This is tough for Pinkins. He's got to call a pass play in here. Look for that tight end again to maybe come off the line of scrimmage, slip out there. But it's going to be, I would like to see him do a roll action. I think he's very effective with that roll where he puts that run pass option on the cornerback and the linebacker on the outside.
Well, they have Demetrius Summers split to the top of your screen. Dacus Terman in the backfield alongside Pinkins. Here comes some pressure from the outside. And Pinkins goes down and fumbles the football. It's loose at the 25. But Pinkins recovers it. And Bruce Bauer just said, I'm sending everybody on the last play of the first quarter. Ohana Jay and Hurley Harrison put the pressure on Dontrell Pinkins.
And Pinkins never saw that backside pressure. He's looking off to the left. His eyes are over that way. And look what he gets hit by. Smash mouth football. That's the way you come in and tackle. All of a sudden you see Vanderbilt playing maybe with a little bit more emotion.
Well, that was the last play of the first quarter that was dominated by South Carolina. The Gamecocks stormed into Vanderbilt Stadium and made their voices heard loud and clear. They lead by 2 touchdowns when we come back to Nashville. Getting set for the start of the second quarter, South Carolina lining up for a what will amount to a 35-yard field goal. Josh Brown is 0 for 2 in his career as a field goal kicker. Will try to make his first in a South Carolina Gamecock uniform. Hold is okay, good. The kick is up. And it is good. So the Gamecocks add to their lead on the Josh Brown 35-yard field goal.
But, Dave, for Vanderbilt, that was a statement. If they let him score 7 points there, you can crank up the band and go away for hot dogs.
Log on to jpsports.com and click on the Regions Bank Road Trip Planner for the quickest routes and all the information you need traveling around the SEC. Cutler out of the shotgun to fire again. As his target, Eric Davis. Some positive yardage. That's a start. Gain of 6.
And Dave, I am really impressed with Rick Minner's defensive scheme here. A lot of people moving to the football. He slants a lot of the linemen, brings his backs, and everybody ran to the football that time. When that ball was thrown, every person ran to that ball. He's doing an excellent job.
Former head coach at Cincinnati for 10 years, but was a defensive coordinator with Lou Holtz at Notre Dame. And that'll be a first down for Vanderbilt. Pass is caught by Eric Davis, a gain of 5, and the crowd applauds. Fred Bennett will get credit for the tackle.
A first down. That's what they're applauding, the first down. Move the chains. If anybody can do it, Jay Cutler can do it.
Davis, 638 yards last year with 8 touchdowns to his credit. They think Davis and Brandon Smith on the other side are two of the better receivers in the league. Cutler to throw. And looking for Marlon White. Incomplete. Coverage by Coe Simpson. Pressure came from Daryl Shropshire.
Dave, one of the things that happens to Vanderbilt, when you get behind by 17 points, you've got an offensive plan. All of a sudden, that offensive plan, you say, hey, we want to run the ball, we want to control it. All of a sudden, you put that out the window. You've got to get back in this football game. That's why I say, though, if somebody can do it, Jay Cutler is the kind of quarterback. We saw how hot he got last year in that South Carolina game. They've got to abandon, they've got to throw the football.
Cutler had plenty of time. Now forced out of the pocket. Throws back over the middle. Pass is caught by Marlon White, the sophomore out of Macon, Georgia. And that'll be a Commodore first down. Coe Simpson on the tackle, but gives some credit to that offensive line to give Jay Cutler some time.
Boy, Cutler makes a nice move right here. Get outside the trouble right there now. Square up, look downfield. Nice catch. Good concentration. Had to go up high. Look that ball in. Help your team. All of a sudden, Vandy's moving it, Dave.
He had 7 or 8 seconds before he had to roll out of that pocket.
Yeah.
Cutler's the kind of guy you don't want to give a lot of time to. McKenzie stands next to his quarterback. It'll be a little keeper. Cutler.
Jay Cutler on the carry.
Got maybe a yard. And a late flag comes in. The Vanderbilt bench all erupted. I didn't see what happened, but all the Vanderbilt players started pointing their finger at the end of that play.
Face mask, 5-yard penalty. Defense number 8. 5 yards will be added at the end of the run. We'll replay second down.
Well, that's Fred Bennett, number 8. He's the guilty person. Let's see if we see it right. Yeah, oh yeah, right there, sure. That's not hard to see. No wonder they erupted on the sideline, Dave.
Well, that's one of the things I think that we'll enjoy up here in the booth and the fans across the country is one of the new implementations in the rule book is to announce the violator of a penalties, and it'll help clear up a lot of question marks as to where it came from. I know coaches have got to like it. Cutler again stands in the pocket, fires a bullet to a wide open receiver on the near side. Chris Young makes the catch. Boy, did he get popped by Jamacia Jackson, but that's a Commodore first down, and now they're moving.
And all of a sudden, Cutler's sitting back there just looking downfield. Watch him here. Look at that line up front block, and now he just throws a dart in there. Excellent catch, good looking, and Cutler is really excited. I mean, he had some emotion.
I think South Carolina playing a little soft defensively, not bringing a lot of pressure, and thus Cutler has time once again to throw wide open over the middle behind his receiver, Marlon White. He was wide open. Somebody missed an assignment in that Gamecock secondary.
Yeah, he threw it behind him because Jamacia Jackson, the defensive safety, was making a cut back inside.
This Vanderbilt offense seems to be clicking. For more on that, let's go down to Buzz.
Dave, what they're doing, they're running a series called Check Me at the Line. They're not going with the huddle. You see Jake Cutler look over to the side. There it is right there. He gets the call from Ted Kane based on what the defense does, and then they set their play. It's been effective in this drive.
It's second down and 10. Fake it to Norval McKenzie, and a flag comes down, and a loose football in the process. South Carolina says they have it. They do. But a flag is down.
That flag is thrown right behind the defensive line. You almost always think of that offside cut, that hold on the backside by an offensive lineman.
And Rodriguez Wilson came up with the fumble recovery, and it will stand.
Holding. Offense 84. Penalty is declined. First down.
Dave, when you're taught from basic elements, you're taught to rip that football out, and that's exactly what they do. Fake right there. Cutler doesn't put the ball away, and look at the second person in there, just rips the football out. Look at the ball just bouncing around in there. Then you start yelling, fire, fire, and everybody scrambles.
Marcus Lawrence was the man who forced that fumble. And now South Carolina has a chance. They have had three drives. They've all produced points so far this afternoon. Pinkins still in at quarterback. Little throwback to the near side. Has his receiver Williamson across the 40 to the 44-yard line. Jaleche Ohanaja makes the tackle. He'll be very close, and yes, they will give him a first down. So a gain of 11 on the play. ...13-11 to go in the second quarter. It's 17-0 South Carolina. An offense that at times last year was sluggish. Looks anything but today. Here's some pressure. Trying to set up the screen to Summers. Pressure came from Robert Dinwiddie, forcing the quick release of the pass. But Dondrell Pinkins today overall, Dave, has done everything Coach Holtz would have asked for.
I've liked this play. He's really mixed it up. This first is a great fake. Look at this. Nonchalant handoff for the reverse. Then he came back and found across the middle, found a dart right there and threw a nice pass. Then that tight end pass, when he's under a lot of pressure, throws it up. It's not pretty, but it was 7 points. A lot of versatility by Dondrell Pinkins.
Passing 4 of 7 for 42 yards. Also has 32 yards rushing today. And I'm still waiting for us to see Savelle Newton, the sophomore out of Wallace, South Carolina, who will also play today. We were guaranteed that by the coaching staff. Wide open over the middle is Troy Williamson. Inside Vanderbilt territory, down to the 37-yard line. That's a first down, a gain of 19 on the play. Kaleche Ohanaja makes the tackle. He already has 9 from his safety spot.
One of the things that you asked Lou Holtz about that offensive line up front, he said, hey, we're pretty solid. No wonder they're solid. Nobody's penetrating in there. Pinkins is just able to look off his first receiver, find inside receivers. Just excellent. Good calls. Good control of the line of scrimmage. Both sides of the ball.
4 receivers set. Here's Pinkins. Little option to Summers. He's got some running room. He's inside the 30 down to the 28-yard line. Hurdley Harrison makes the stop. That'll be a gain of 8.5, 9 on the play.
And all of a sudden you get the feeling that South Carolina said, hey, they drove the football on. Let's take it back. And as we were talking yesterday with the coaches, the best defense sometimes is a great offense. South Carolina has controlled the line.
And Savelle Newton does step onto the field. Number 13 is under center. The lightning quick and athletic quarterback hands it off on his first possession to Andre Goss, the senior out of Conway. To Dondrell Pinkins, knew that he was going to be spelled a couple of times today, and Savelle Newton was going to be the man. Savelle, not the throwing quarterback, but just a tremendous athlete. And I'm anxious to see what kind of package they have constructed for Savelle.
Yeah, use a lot of motion, use a lot of down the line. Had an incredible spring game. They said he passed for 275 yards. So we may see a little bit of that passing arm.
In the shotgun is Savelle. Comes near side. Will keep it. Not much happening. Gets a couple, and that'll be a second down situation coming up for the Gamecocks. Eric Byram makes the tackle for Vandy.
Well, you know, I don't want to be critical, but South Carolina's controlled the line of scrimmage. Now you bring those delay plays where you've got your quarterback running the line of scrimmage. Hey, I go right back to the big boys up front.
Look at those rushing yards. 146 for South Carolina. Flag is down. Lou Holtz is not happy on his sideline. I'm anxious to see what that'll be about.
Illegal substitution.
Ooh.
12th man come in and all players broke the huddle. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
This is not a happy man when you take off that headset. Wonder how many headsets he goes through. At least he doesn't throw his hat. But what happens is there's no deception in the league anymore in college football. You can't break the huddle with 12 and run one to the sideline. In other words, have somebody following him out and thinking that he's an active player.
And another thing is you can't huddle on the sideline in a big group and then run right to the field. You have to give the defense an opportunity
exactly.
to position themselves.
Excellent point, Dave.
So Newton throws it to Summers wide open. Summers inside the 20. Selman falls off. He'll be a few yards shy of that first down. Bill Alford makes the tackle. That's only the ninth pass of the day for South Carolina. They have run the ball 26 times, thrown it 9 times. Last year, at the end of the season, they actually threw it 57% of the time, ran it 43%. So I would say that there is a dramatic change in the offensive philosophy here at South Carolina.
Absolutely. They're still trying to develop that fullback. They don't really have a fullback to play. But they've got some good halfbacks that are going to play. In Summers and Boyd, of course, Gonzi Gray, who started this football game.
Newton on a little keeper. Tried to run the option, but Vanderbilt read it very well. And that'll bring up a fourth down situation. Jovan Hay makes his first stop of the afternoon.
Well, Jovan Hay is such a strong player. Watch him in here. He's going to run the line. You get up inside, rip him up inside, right down the line. You play across the face of the blocker. That's as well as you can play from the backside and make a tackle.
Dave, that's got to be a tough block for a tight end on Jovan Hay.
It is. What you do is you're trying to get your head in front of him, and he just ripped through the head, played across the face.
27 rushes out of 36 plays. Joey Bowers connected from 35 earlier. Or excuse me, Josh Brown. This will be from 37. And it is no good wide left. For the first time today, the Gamecocks come away empty-handed. Wherever you go. I don't think there are many Vanderbilt fans today that would consider themselves Lou Holtz fans. As the Commodores trail by 17. You know, both these clubs returned a lot of people. South Carolina 16, Vanderbilt 21. And this is very similar to what happened last year in Columbia with South Carolina jumping out to a huge lead. Vandy made a game of it in the second half, but never really a threat. Brandon Smith with the catch. That'll be a first down. Gain of 12. Closed captioning for SEC football provided by Nissan and your Nissan dealer. In the second half last year, after Vanderbilt fell behind by 25 points, it was 28-3. Cutler with 21-23 throwing the football in the second half. Really put on a show, but you can't fall behind by these kind of numbers in the SEC and expect that you can come away with a victory every weekend.
No, but if I had a quarterback that I'd want to try to put it in the hands of, it might be Jay Cutler.
Cutler keeps it and gets it near the 40-yard line. Gain of 9 on the play. But our quarterbacks both returned, Dondrell Pinkins and Jay Cutler, and this is what they did. Jay had a career-high 319 yards, 3 touchdowns, but Pinkins did it on the ground, averaging 5 yards a carry, and he scored 3 touchdowns. So pretty much what we expected out of these two quarterbacks, one more of a runner than a thrower. Cutler lost it up in the air. That's Chris Young, his Hawkeye, got a first down. Chris Young, the senior out of Batesville, Mississippi, who has been voted a captain this year. There's Don Terrell English.
Yeah, he's sitting there. He's not done a bad job. He's not been replaced because he has done a bad job. In fact, he's led his team to the lead. He's just he's got a great talent behind him. Boy, what a job Rick Minter's done. Talk about defensive coordinator changing the complexion, movement, getting people to the football.
The play action to Doster Cutler. Throws over the middle, has his man open. It's caught by Eric Davis down inside the 15-yard line. They'll spot it at the 10. Oh, Simpson ran him out of bounds. That play's been open a couple of times. They just haven't connected. And that's a huge gain, and it's got to be a confidence builder in the process.
Dave, good line protection up front. This direction, look at this. Good wall of blockers. He's coming this way. He's going to look back across the field, and he's going to see the crossing pattern. Well-thrown ball. Square up those shoulders, and he finds Eric Davis on that crossing pattern. That's the Jay Cutler that they need.
Gain of 43 on the play. Davis picks up 58 yards to this point in the game on three receptions. Here's Quanay Doster inside the five. Preston Thorne makes the tackle for South Carolina.
Huge opportunity here if you're Vanderbilt. You get back in the football game if you score. I saw a little different spark into Quanay Doster on that run, Dave. When he got to the hole, he burst through. You know, he had the fumble problems last year. Had just a really disappointing year. He ran with some explosion into the hole.
Doster, the 2002 SEC Freshman of the Year, gets the handoff and gets 6 points in the process.
This play works. Stamper and Pyle, the block up front, the two guard and tackle, drove him down, and then Doster saw the cutback and just made it. I could have run that ball in. Great line surge by the guard and the tackle, Stamper and Pyle.
Jay Cutler stays on the field to hold for his kicker, Patrick Johnson, attempting the point after. It's a bad snap. Cutler is dropped. That won't dampen Quanay Doster's happiness after he picks up a touchdown. And now there's a spark for Vanderbilt. We'll be back after work from your local stations. Vanderbilt gets on the board, but they still trail by 11. 6:44 to go in the second quarter from Nashville. Dave Neal, Dave Rowe, and Dave Buzz Baker. We open up the 72nd season of SEC football. 13th straight right here on Jefferson Island Sports. Romanes to kick it off. Troy Williamson will take it at the goal line. Williamson still on his feet. Out to the 25. Nice return. Vanderbilt's scoring drive went 80 yards. Doster capped it off with a 4-yard run. The point after failed, but it was a big throw and catch from Jay Cutler to Eric Davis that went 43 yards that set up that touchdown.
Man, that's when the coach is gnawing on you right there. Bobby Johnson went out there. What happened was when he made the tackle, he didn't wrap him up. And Bobby Johnson is such a perfectionist. That's the first thing you teach. Get those arms up. Wrap them around. You don't knock these people down with a roll block.
Pinkett's back in a quarterback, and he'll throw it. Going up top. Ball was caught and then dropped. They'll say he never had possession. Bill Alford popped him. Thomas got hit pretty hard. He's already left the game limping earlier in the first quarter.
Boy,
seems
Pinkins
to be all right.
Pinkins, look at the time he has. Good pass right here. Now goes up for it. No, he got knocked. The ball got knocked out. Alford just stuck him on the ball. Watch Alford come in there. He's going to stick him right there. Right, puts his hat right on the ball. That's exactly what you want to teach.
So it's second and 10.
Don't you get the feeling, Dave, that Vandy's playing with a lot more emotion? That score really helped him.
Flags are down, late flags nonetheless.
I wonder if the time clock ran out.
For the snap.
Nope.
Dead ball, false start. Offense, number 60. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Well, you can win a brand new Polaris ATP 500, the exceptional all-terrain pickup with twice the hauling capacity of most ATVs. The lucky winner and a guest will also join us at our final SEC football telecast of the year. For details and to register, log on to jpsports.com. Polaris, the way out. So now we're looking at second and 15.
Boy, huge series right here. If you're Vanderbilt, you can stop them. You're going to get the ball in good field position. If you're South Carolina, don't make a mistake. Don't throw the ball into trouble. Here comes pressure.
Vanderbilt sent some heat from the linebacker position. Moses Osemigi makes the tackle on Gonzi Gray. Gain of 2.5 on the play. And that'll bring up a long third down.
And it's a tough down for Dondrell Pinkins. He can't force the ball in there. Oh, they thought they made a change for a second, but they didn't. But Pinkins can't force the ball in. Don't make a mistake.
Pinkins overthrows Troy Williamson, and the Vanderbilt defense holds. Pressure came from Robert Dinwiddie. And South Carolina will punt for the first time today. Josh Brown will punt it away to Eric Davis. Davis stands at the 35. Good snap. And a flag is down at the line of scrimmage. Davis calls for a fair catch. It'll be good field position for Vanderbilt if that punt holds up. We'll wait on the call. Well, it's possibly one of those didn't have enough on the line of scrimmage calls.
Well, South Carolina spread out. They spread across the field. They may not have. We'll hear it right here.
Illegal formation. Not enough players on the line of scrimmage. Penalty is declined. First down.
So Vanderbilt will get good field position at the 44 when we come back after this message from Pontiac and the G6 driving experience. We go in the second quarter. Vanderbilt fell behind 17-0 as South Carolina scored on their opening three possessions. Vandy responded with a touchdown on their last drive, and now they start at the 44. First down and 10 in the I formation. Play action, Cutler to fire. Pass is dropped by Eric Davis. Pass was a little bit low. Fred Bennett on the coverage.
Boy, Davis has been his go-to receiver. He's gone to him several times. He's had success. Good looking, good hands. I think you go right back to him. He's your home run player. Second and 10.
Last year in the opener, Davis had a coming out party against Ole Miss. He had 6 catches for 138 yards in that tough defeat right here in Nashville a year ago. Cutler fires. And that was nearly picked off by Coe Simpson, and there was nothing but green grass and goal line in his way.
Wow. That was a home run. Cutler avoided a huge mistake. He throws a drag out to the flat. Simpson cuts right inside of it. Just about had it. Look at this. It's a long pass for about 4 yards. Look at the break on the ball that Simpson had back underneath. He had nothing ahead. Just goal line.
Simpson, he was heading for that hospitality tent in the end zone. Third down and 10 now.
Me, I'd go right back to Eric Davis. He's been the one that's gotten open, especially on that crossing pattern.
Pressure comes. Cutler goes down. We haven't seen South Carolina bring the heat much here in the last few series, but they did that time, and it paid off.
Well, That's what Rick Minner likes. He likes to mix up the defense, come after him. This time he gets the big man in the middle. They collapse the pocket. No place for Cutler to get outside. Again, look at that. Good move inside. Good overarm swim move inside. That's what penetrated the pocket. Keep on working. The big men up front, that made the difference on that play.
Dropshire and Coley in on the sack for South Carolina. Noah Whiteside on the return. Not much happening. Let's check in with Buzz, who's found a, I guess you might say, somebody we might get quite familiar with in the coming weeks.
Yeah, you may already be, Dave. There are a lot of firsts in the SEC. MJ Garrett was a guy who played here at Vanderbilt, 59 career receptions, over 1,000 yards. He had a 219-yard game here for Vandy when he played here, graduated in 2002. Now he's a star, the MTV's Real World Philadelphia, which debuts on Tuesday.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, it's just great to be back, seeing my guys. I mean, I know all these players, and I was away from them for 4 months. It's just great to be back.
Seven of you in a house, is that right?
That's right. Seven of us from all different areas of the country. And you're pretty much stuck in a house with six people that you work with.
Here's Summers, and there will be a flag. There was an obvious hold on that play.
Yeah, it was Justin Geisinger. It was
William Brown of South Carolina.
Yeah, it was William Brown of South Carolina. It was just locked up with him. We saw that one all the way to the sideline.
Holding. Offense number 71, 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
All right, let's go back down to Buzz.
All right, Dave, MJ's used to this with all those cameras around you for the show. Tougher physically to play in the SEC, but I can't imagine anything tougher mentally than the real.
Emotionally, it's so draining. I mean, for everybody, it's entertainment for everybody watching the show. But when you actually go through it, you learn so much about yourself and kind of who you are. And the diversity is what I really like. You know, coming from Nashville, I just was kind of in my bubble and kind of got to go out there, kind of find myself and find out about other people.
10 o'clock Tuesday night Eastern, 9 Central, The Real World with MJ Garrett. Thanks, MJ.
Watch it.
Thank you, Buzz. I might tune in for that. Here's Summers. Gets the handoff. Met about 2 yards past the line of scrimmage by Otis Washington. Speaking of Otis Washington, they really need him to step up. He's got a freshman right on his heels named Jonathan Goff, who they expect great things from. But Otis played every game last year. They said that, you know, Otis was a guy that practiced so well a year ago but couldn't transfer that into play on Saturdays. And Otis, by his own admission, says he needs to step it up this year in that middle linebacker position.
Oh, he's a big-time tackle. I mean, big-time linebacker. He can move the ball. He's got excellent speed. They just want him to play like he practices.
5'11", not a big man, 235 pounds. Here's Pinkins. He has all day to throw, and he has a wide-open receiver. Troy Williamson at the 40-yard line into Vanderbilt territory. Galecki Ohanaja makes this, I guess you could say, touchdown-saving tackle. Williamson, a big play receiver, nearly pulled off another huge one.
You want to see a breaking play. Watch this. Williamson's so wide open, there's nobody near him. Breakdown in coverage. Has to be. A lot of time back there. I'm surprised. But look at this. Nobody even close. If Ohanaja doesn't come over and make that tackle.
Last year against Vanderbilt, averaged 17 yards on 5 catches. Here's the handoff to Dacus Turman. He bounces around. Comes back near side. Finally dragged down by Morris and Ohanaja. Kelechi already with 11 tackles. Ohanaja is a big-time hitter. Had 99 tackles a year ago. A couple of interceptions to his credit, but has been a busy, busy man. And a lot of those tackles have been 10 yards past the line of scrimmage. This is what Vanderbilt thought was a pretty deep and talented secondary, and they're getting a big-time workout today. Here's Pinkins on the keeper. It's a couple that'll be third down and about 4, and one guy we haven't heard much from. We've heard about Ohanaja all day, but Jovan Hay, big day, bro.
Well, he's got double teamed, turned inside, tried to come around backside a block. He's gotten tied up in there where he's just gotten locked up one-on-one, and he's going around blocks. Again, you can't get locked up. You've got to get separation. You've got to get away from those guys. Hay is most effective when he's in the backfield making those tackles using his speed. 3 tackles is not normal for Jovan Hay.
Third down, 3 to go. Here's a little option. Pinkins has a hole. Dondrell inside the 25, down to the 21. Ohanaja once again with the stop, but they'll move the chains after the gain of 13.
Boy, Pinkins read that as well as you can read it. Watch Pinkins.
He's got to read this play. He's got two fakes on it, crossed in front of him now. He's got the toss out there or turn up.
He knows he needs 3 or 4 yards. He saw the opening, breaks through, good vision by him. Still had the toss if he needed it.
90 seconds to go before halftime. Here's the handoff. Goes to Gonzi Gray. Not much happening. Give him a couple on the play. USC averaged 161 yards a game last year. That was fourth in the SEC. You know, you started hearing that they just really were struggling offensively. It's not a bad number to finish fourth in the league. But Lou Holtz, when I asked him directly, I said, what kind of number do you want on a weekly basis? And he said 230 yards. But I don't know that you can get that playing the defense as you do in the SEC. But today they are well on their way.
I'm really surprised that the clock management, Dave, they're not calling timeout. They're just letting the clock tick down.
Another play action. Pinkins will throw it back. Summers through his fingertips. Incomplete. That'll stop the clock at 38 seconds. Moses Asimogee on the coverage for Bobby Johnson's Commodores. How about this time of possession here? And there's still some time left, Dave. South Carolina has had the ball for 18 minutes and 30 seconds. 7 minutes and roughly 10 seconds for Vanderbilt.
Well, Vanderbilt ought to count their blessings. They're only down by 11 because I want to tell you something. South Carolina has controlled this football game. But it really surprised me in that last series. That last series took off with about a minute and 20 seconds. It got down to 38 seconds. They got nothing out of it. It's just like they're ready to settle for a field goal.
South Carolina had to burn a timeout right before the end of the first quarter, so they have two left. Dondrell Pinkins will throw it. As his target, Corey Boyd out of the backfield inside the 15.
Where's the timeout? No timeout?
Well, it's fourth down. They'll probably try to just tick this down as far as they can and just make the field goal the last play. And that's exactly what they're looking at. Lou Holtz looking at that clock. It's down to 8 seconds.
See, I'm an old defensive player. I always go for the throat, you know. You got a chance to score a touchdown, you score one.
Well, they'll stop it with 2 seconds to go. South Carolina is 1 of 2 today in the field goal department. Josh Brown hit from 35, missed from 37. And we have got plenty of halftime activities coming your way. Dave Baker in charge of all those. Let's check in with him.
Take a look at scores and highlights from around the conference, Dave, on this opening weekend. So many games, so many big stories. We've got the latest for you. We'll hear from Lou Holtz and Bobby Johnson at halftime as well. That's all coming up right after this kick.
All right, Buzz. How is it down there? Is it hot?
Somewhat steamy today. I would say juicy would be a term you might hear your local meteorologist use.
Juicy?
We got a little rain right before the game, and then it just kind of steamed up. I'll tell you exactly what it's like. It's like those days, if Dave can remember that far, back when they did two-a-days. And, you know, they used to have that dew on the grass in the morning, and then it got steamy and you couldn't catch a breath of air. The southern term is tight.
It is a tight day for the defense as well. Vanderbilt's been out there all day long. You know, also, we will be joined by the commissioner of the SEC, Mike Slive, will join us at the beginning of the second half. So a lot coming your way over the next half hour. Please stay with us right here on Jefferson Pilot Sport. Now, this field goal attempt from 32 yards away.
And Vandy's gotten a great push in the middle. See if they can get some penetration. Get those hands up.
Good snap. Good hold. Kick is on the way. And it's no good. This one's wide right. Couple of missed field goals. About the only thing that went wrong for Carolina fans today. 17-6, they have the halftime lead heading into that locker room. Dave Baker down on the field trying to catch up with Coach Holtz on the way. That probably won't make him a real happy man as he discusses the situation with Josh Brown. And let's send it on down to Dave Baker, who's with the coach.
Coach, you were able to establish a line of scrimmage right off in this one.
Well, we have to do that, but we We're having trouble with the field goal kicking. We're having trouble when we get down there. We've had far too many penalties. We put ourselves in too big of a bind. We've had too far to go. We haven't capitalized on what we need to do.
All right, thanks, Coach. Best of luck second half. Despite all that, Lou Holtz's Gamecocks go to the locker room with a 17-6 lead over the homestanding
Southeastern Conference, especially if you go swimming, track, and field. I mean, it's amazing. Everybody in the right. Heats were from the Southeastern Conference.
I thought it was our conference championship track meet half the time that I was watching. But we had about 138 current or former SEC student-athletes competing in the Olympics, Dave. And that's one of the things we're very proud of as much as we are in football, is the kind of depth and strength that we provide with almost 5,000 student-athletes competing in our conference.
Second half kickoff is underway. Quanay Doster takes it at the goal line. Quanay Doster has a little bit of a wall. Gets it out over the 20 to the 23-yard line. A 24-yard return. And certainly Vanderbilt has to step it up offensively. You see their first three possessions were not very impressive. Three and out. Then it was a punt. So gained 1 yard. But they did have that nice drive, Dave Rowe. 80 yards for a touchdown.
Commissioner, I know you love that term, student athlete, and I think you're putting a lot of emphasis on that, aren't you?
We are, Dave. You know, it's we want our kids to play for the national championship in every sport we sponsor, and we want them to get an education and graduate. And when I talk to the kids, I tell them that what we want for them is to be productive, good citizens, and have a happy, courageous life based on the experience they had as student athletes.
Absolutely.
Chris Young on the reverse, and I know you're going to Starkville tonight after you leave here today, and be over there on hand to watch Sylvester Croom take over. What kind of lingering impact has that had? He's hired 7 months ago. Since we're starting the football season again, is it still going to be as big an impact today as it was 6 months ago?
Well, I think the great thing about it is that Sylvester Croom has shown people the kind of coach that he is, and that's why he was hired. And they're going to hand out shirts tonight to say that the only color that counts is maroon. And there'll be about 55,000 people in at that game tonight to start off the Sylvester Croom era, and we're all very proud of that.
Exciting era in the SEC, exciting era in Starkville, Mississippi, and thank you for coming up and spending some time with us. I know we'll see you a lot down the road.
Look forward. It's always great to be with you guys. Thank you,
Commissioner. Mike Sly, so Commissioner of the SEC, joining us here. Vanderbilt, South Carolina in the SEC opener, 72nd season of SEC football. Flag on the play. We'll repeat second down. Commissioner traveling along with Bobby Gaston.
Oh, that's some pretty good traveling company.
Bobby Gaston, supervisor of SEC officials on hand today. He's an observer this afternoon's game. Probably didn't think it was going to be a busy day. The two least penalized teams in the SEC. Second down and 7. Cutler to throw. Marlon White makes the catch. That'll be a Commodore first down. Fred Bennett makes the tackle.
Huge first series for Vandy. You've made your corrections. Good in the pocket. Stay back there. Look downfield. Good block up the top there by Geisinger. They have got to give Cutler time, and they've got to go to a passing game. If they can drive down and score this game, the complexion of this football game is going to change greatly.
Fresh set of downs for Jay Cutler. Single setback, Norval McKenzie. Two receivers to the top, one to the bottom. Here's McKenzie. And McKenzie had a chance to break that for a lot more, but his right tackle, Brian Stamper, got out in front of him and actually missed a block.
Absolutely. Stamper should have turned back inside. He needed to pick up the backer coming across.
Gain of 5, so that'll set up a good play call situation for Ted Kane, the offensive coordinator. There is Ted.
Fun guy to talk to, isn't he?
Oh, I mean, he is.
Animated.
Full of energy.
Oh, gosh.
Single setback again is Norval McKenzie. Here's Norval. He is crushed at the line of scrimmage. Ricardo Hurley, the sophomore out of Greenwood, South Carolina, bothered by injuries a year ago, considered out of high school one of the top linebackers in America, if not the top linebacker.
Coaches tell you tackle through them, don't tackle to them. This is a stick. Watch this. Come up in there and bam! You just hit him there. Fill that hole. Be square. Wrap him up.
Norval, not a small boy, by 5'11", 215 pounds. Met his match with Ricardo Hurley. So third down and five. Cutler to throw. Ball's dropped out of bounds, but it did cross the line as the first down marker.
Wow, where'd that fumble go out of bounds?
Brandon Smith.
Look right there.
Now, South Carolina wants it to be incomplete. Brandon Smith says it should be a completion, and then he fumbled it out of bounds.
And Lou Holtz is right there.
Turn out of the fumble, and fourth down.
It was a reception. Jonathan Joseph, the junior out of Rock Hill, South Carolina, makes the tackle, but that'll be about 2 yards shy of the first down.
Yeah, you can see he was hit right there. That's where they're going.
If he fumbled it out of bounds, that's close to the first down marker.
Bobby Johnson saying, wait a minute, whoa, what's that?
Romanesh to punt it away. Fair catch called for by Noah Whiteside at about the 11-yard line. Bell football fans, register for your chance to win $1 million in the Bell South Kick for a Million contest. One lucky family will be given the opportunity to kick for $1 million during halftime of the 2004 Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl. Log on to jpsports.com to register and then start practicing your field goals. Bell South, listening, answering. By contrast to what Vanderbilt did on their first three possessions, look what South Carolina did. 88 yards, 39 yards, 43 yards.
But look at their last three. Missed field goal, punt, missed field goal. That's the only reason that this football game is close. South Carolina had three extra opportunities, came away with no points.
Robert Dinwiddie steps up from his tackle spot. Big hit on Demetrius Summers. Gain of two.
Dave, I really like the play of Dondrell Pinkins in that first half. I think he's had a lot of passing attempts. He's had yardage. He's not thrown in trouble. He's carried the football. You see there, 47 yards, 12 carries. He's mixed it up. Hey, there's some fans. Look at that. Hey, they're having lunch. Wait a minute. Hey, they brought their lunch with them.
Pinkins swings it out to a wide open Corey Boyd, who slips a couple of tackles. Corey Boyd, not with great breakaway speed, dragged down at the Vanderbilt 40-yard line by Moses Asimaji. A huge gain. And just missed tackles after the 47-yard pickup.
Nothing will hurt you more than missed tackles. Watch this in here. Now he's way outside. Now look, there's one. There's another one coming up in here. You just can't allow them to miss tackles. Vanderbilt has had 8 missed tackles today. This one just adds to it right there. That's another one that adds to the total. They'll kill you.
Pinkins with a little options. Here's Summers. Close to the 30-yard line. That should be a gain of about 10. It'll be close to the first down. Hanajah and Washington make the tackle. How about Kelechi from the safety spot for Vanderbilt? 14 tackles already today.
Well, that's because they're breaking through the line into the secondary, and he's having to come up and make tackles. You don't want your free safety making that number of tackles.
In the first half, South Carolina ran 48 plays to Vanderbilt's 23. Here's a little option, the pitch. DeAndre Gause loses a yard, maybe two. Ohanajah and Osimaji in on the tackle.
And Osimaji played that play as well as you can. He read it all the way. Look at this. Get to the outside. Don't get hooked right there. Square up now. Come back in there. Get those arms on him. Wrap him up. That's the way you play outside backer. That's why he was their leading tackler last year.
Huge numbers for Moses from the linebacker position. Second in the league in tackles. He had 10.5 tackles for loss. 8 double-figure tackle games with a high of 13, which came twice, and bothered with really an injury throughout the season. Gonzi Gray makes the catch. Gets it inside the 25. Now to about the 22. That'll be a couple of yards shy of the first down.
Boy, good block that time. Jonathan Alston out there leading the play. He had Ohanajah. He just knocked him off his feet. what made that play plus yardage. Could have been dropped in the backfield. Plus yardage, result of a great block.
5-6-7.
Split backs behind Pinkins. They'll run the options. Pinkins will keep it. And all he needed was about a yard and a half for the first down. And that will be enough. He got about 3.5 on the play. So first and 10 now for South Carolina back inside that red zone.
Dave, when you're not getting penetration, these coaches, they know what they'll do. All you have to do is just give them the Pinkins, let them keep it. Coaches are saying, hey, just keep on rolling with the ball. Don't you know the Skip Holtz, who's right there, he's enjoying it. On the other side, that's Bruce Fowler. He's the defensive coordinator for Vanderbilt. He's saying, hey, we got to get penetration. We got to get in the backfield. You got to do something to disrupt.
Couple of tight ends in the game. Little play action fake. A nice one. Pinkins throws, but his pass is batted in the air. Dominique Morris came from his corner and disrupted that play.
Boy, if he doesn't touch that ball, Gonzi Gray is in the end zone with 7 points. That's why you get your hands up. Watch Gray. He's going to keep on going out of the backfield. He's wide open. He's over here all by himself. Nobody there. Big play by Dominique Morris, number 10. Again, get those hands up.
Well, the sun now comes back out here in Nashville on a warm, muggy afternoon. Red zone offense. Here's Pinkins. Falls forward inside the 10. Down to about the 9-yard line. Kevin Joyce dragged him down.
Dave, we're looking at offensive players. I was watching John Strickland, 74, get out there, reach out there, block. He's the center. Javon Hay, nowhere to go. He just gets taken on the line. He's knocked down. Boy, they have controlled him all day. That is really surprising to me. And the Vandy players all have their hands on their hips. They're tired.
Hey, they've been on the football field for 27 minutes so far this afternoon. It looks like a timeout.
Timeout, South Carolina.
Taken by South Carolina. One other thing, addition to the rule change, is now coaches don't have to rely on players to call timeouts. They can actually do it from the sidelines. We'll step aside. Back in a moment. 150 yards through the air, 60 yards on the ground. Looking at a third down and one inside the 10. And Dondrell keeps it. And should have plenty for the first down. Kevin Joyce will make the tackle. And they will move the chains and bring a first down and goal from the 7.
This play works because you've got a quarterback that comes down the line and reads the hole. He knows how far he only has to get. He only has to get 1 or 2 yards. He gets behind Perman, gets that block, reads it, picks up the first down. He has played a wonderful football game today. Hasn't made a mistake yet.
Here's Boyd. Touchdown, South Carolina. 7 yards. Dave, I look at that Vanderbilt defense, and they all have their hands on their hips.
Yep.
They are getting worn down.
Well, I watched Jabari Levy that time on Hay, and I mean, he just crushed him. Again, look at Levy right here. He just crushes Javon Hay. I mean, he pushes him in the backfield. Hay is just exhausted. He's playing against 25, 30 pounds heavier man. He's just sapped his strength. Didn't even touch Boyd.
Going after is up and good. Javon Levy, considered one of the better tacklers in all of college football, showing his skills. And South Carolina has expanded their lead 24-6 over the Commodores. Well, South Carolina picked up right where they started this game with a very forceful opening drive to the second half that results in a Corey Boyd 7-yard touchdown run, 24-6. The Gamecocks out in front. Juan A. Doster stands at his goal line to return this kickoff from Joey Bowers. Good kickoff in the right corner of the end zone, and Doster will have to take a knee. Time for our Safe Auto Insurance successful drive, and this one went 89 yards. Kind of a short drive time-wise, only 4:46. South Carolina has put together some lengthy drives today in terms of time. And boy, with that 7-yard touchdown run, and that successful drive means another $500 to the SEC's Education Initiative, courtesy of Safe Auto Insurance Company. Call 1-800-SAFE-AUTO, and you too could be a successful driver. So Jay Cutler not having a great day. 4 rushes, just 4 yards. He has completed 11 of 17 passes for 121 yards. We'll go to the air again. Looking up top and over the outstretched hand of Eric Davis. Jamacia Jackson on the coverage. Cutler just not really in the groove right now.
Running game has just not been there today, of course, for Vanderbilt. You can see that by those stats. 3 carries, no yards. 2 carries, 10 yards. It does surprise me. I really thought McKenzie would come in and establish, keep on picking. But all of a sudden, they had to change the game plan, especially in the second half, Dave. Now it's not going to be a running game. Now it's going to be strictly passing. It does surprise me.
That's through the hands of Brandon Smith. And Jay Cutler now getting a little upset at some of his receivers.
Well, that's uncharacteristic of Cutler. You don't point fingers. You tell him to run routes, and I think that's probably what he was trying to do, but he's trying to get some motivation in his huddle. Third down, they don't want to give the ball right back up again.
You know, the defensive guys would say, just give me another minute.
Exactly.
Nickel package in for South Carolina. 4 wide receivers set for the Commodores. Doster in the backfield alongside Cutler on 3rd down and 10 from the 20. Cutler has plenty of time. Pass is caught by Brandon Smith, and that'll be a first down. South Carolina just dropped back to defend the pass. Not much pressure, and Cutler had too much time.
Yeah, really a little bit interesting defensive scheme on this play. Rick Minner and his defensive coordinate just electing to run 3, just trying to pressure for 3, drop 8, and it gives Cutler too much time. He gets out of the pocket, finds his receiver downfield. Got to put a little bit more pressure on him.
Boy, that was a huge first down.
Oh,
if nothing else, just for the defense. Cutler to throw again over the middle. Has Marlon White. That'll be a first down.
Dave, I really like Cutler when he's throwing these cutting passes, these crossing passes here. Little play action fake. Now pick him up and throw a dart to the inside. As long as the strong safety doesn't come that way, he's got a little dart. He's just throwing and leading them. I like him on those crossing plays. Keep going to him. From South Carolina.
Matthew Tant, the fullback, back in the game. He stands in front of Quanay Doster. He lines up 7 yards deep. 1st and 10 from the 39. Here's Quanay. Nothing happening. The front of that South Carolina defense. Marcus Lawrence, the middle linebacker, plugs that hole. Take a look at our Aaron scoreboard. Oklahoma 20 better than Bowling Green in the third quarter. Michigan 24-9. Ohio State leading Cincinnati. Dow taking care of Air Force, and Virginia having a little trouble. Wisconsin also out in front of Central Florida in the fourth quarter. George O'Leary making his debut, but actually not, because he is not with the team. He is tending to some family matters back in his hometown. Cutler scrambling, now running. Cutler to about the 31-yard line. Pressure came from Mo Thompson. First time we've called Mo's name.
Yeah. Today. Talked about the great ends that South Carolina had in Dawson. Mo Thompson, look at this time sitting back here. Everybody's picked up. Now, you use those legs of Cutler. He's got great speed to get to the outside. He's a good runner. Picks up as much yardage as he can. Look at it. There's the defensive coordinator, Rick Minner, saying, hey, don't let him outside. We said that we were going to control him. That was one of the things that he said to you, Dave. Had to keep him in the pocket.
Well, Cutler, very dangerous runner. It felt like if they could keep him in the pocket, they'd have a better chance against him. Here's a little option. Doster with the pitch. Needs a couple of yards for the first down, and he gets it. That little stutter step I thought might have cost him the first down, but he picks it up. Cody Wells and George Goss converge on the tackle. A gain of three. He needed two.
Yeah, but he had to hear those footsteps. George Goss coming down there, about 275 running down his throat. But they keep the drive alive. They move the chains. Got a little bit more life.
Not panic time yet.
No, it's not.
Plenty of time. 5.5 to go here in the third quarter. McKenzie back in the game behind the fullback Tan. But Cutler will throw it. Swing it far side. Chris Young breaks a tackle. Still on his feet. Touchdown, Vanderbilt. Oh, they'll say he's out of bounds at the 12. At the 12-yard line, this tackle by Jermaine Tyler and Coach Simpson, but at least they had enough impetus to knock him out of bounds at the 12. That'll be a first down.
Separation. Look at the distance from the defender to the receiver. Now he catches the ball. He's able to turn up. Now watch that foot. See if he steps on the line. I didn't see it from that angle. Now let's look from this angle. Right.
He did.
Wow. There it is. Yeah.
His right foot.
Yep, he did.
Got hung up by fractions.
Way too much separation. You can't give him 8, 10 yards.
Play action. Cutler to throw a bullet. And that'll be a flag. Jonathan Joseph a little bit early in trying to defend Marlon White. Came over the left shoulder. And that'll get a flag nearly every time.
Yeah, he had that arm up on his back shoulder trying to reach in front of him to cause the interference. Watch the back hand on the shoulder. See if we see it. Yeah, see that back hand on the shoulder right there? He's pulling that back arm back. Again, there you go. See that right hand? That's the arm that gets him. Good call.
That's a tough pass to defend. I mean,
it's really difficult because that's Cutler's bread and butter. That's what he can throw, that dart. I told you I like those crossing patterns. It's hard to take that away from him.
Couple of tight ends in the game on first and goal from the two. Norval McKenzie stopped short of the goal line. Norval McKenzie, about 20, 25 pounds bigger than Quanay Doster, and is their tackle-to-tackle guy.
And Dave, when you're in this situation and you're a slanting defense, you either guess right or you guess wrong. If you guess right, you can get that defense into the secondary and make a stop. If you guess wrong, there's a big hole.
And the power lead again. Loose football. Who's got it? It's a touchback. South Carolina. Mo Thompson falls on top of the football. And on second and goal from the one, the Commodores come away with nothing. The Gamecocks with yet another big play.
Unbelievable. He was trying to reach out with the ball to get it across the goal line. That was incredible. Watch this. Watch it. The tail end trying to reach out. See right there? And the ball, when he comes down, it bangs off one of the defenders. And there's the fumble again. Watch this. Up high, when he reaches out is when he gets in trouble. His knee was not on the ground, so that's a live ball.
I'm wondering if that ball, that looked very close to actually hitting the ground.
I think it bounced off one of the backs of the defenders who was down underneath.
Second fumble today gives it back to the Gamecocks. Corey Boyd tackled by Otis Washington. Boy, and that is a backbreaker.
That's a big nail, let me tell you. That really looms big. Just that extra effort. But what about the South Carolina line? They slanted. They guessed right. They got good penetration in there. The linebackers came up. There was no way for him to break the plane of reaching over with the ball, and he fumbles. It's up play there, recovering that football, Mo Thompson.
Jenkins breaking some tackles. Brings about 7 on the play. Ohanaja with yet another tackle today. Otis Washington in the middle had a chance to stop him for a gain of about two or three. That'll bring up a third down and I'd say two and a half, maybe three. And Savelle Newton back in the game. 195-pound sophomore, played three snaps in the first half. And look at the total yards in this game, rushing the football.
36 yards by the Commodores. Who would have thought that?
Here's Newton. He'll get across the 30, and he'll pick up the first down. Wasn't pretty, but it was effective. Lorenzo Parker and Osimiji combined for the tackle. Clock moves 3:07.
Safest play in football. Just snap it right to him. Let him just put it away. He's running. He doesn't need a whole lot of yards. No handoff. No mistakes. Keep the clock cranking.
There's Dondrell watching Savelle at quarterback. Three wide receivers to the near side. Shotgun for Newton. And Savelle is popped at the line of scrimmage.
In that last series, South Carolina just drilled the ball down the field. Got broke tackles there. Boy, you see him on a long run. Then Pinkins making good decisions, keeping the football stretching for the yards. Then they gave it to Boyd, and he went in just untouched. The offensive line controlling the line of scrimmage. That's what's made South Carolina click today.
And Dondrell Pinkins back in the game at quarterback. On second and eight. Wide open the flat. It's Corey Boyd, and he...
Ouch, that hurt.
Got his foot or cleats caught in the grass, and then his leg just buckled.
Boy, you just saw him just cringing go down. That is painful. He was just a little safety valve sitting out here in the flat. Pinkins just turned through it to him. Nobody touched him on the play. You see Lou Holtz there. Look at Lou Holtz right in there. Again, how he came down, little safety valve out to the flat here, and watch when he puts his feet down right in here. You see him reaching? Again, let's say, maybe we'll see it a little better here. Again, when he turns, watch the feet come down. Oh, look at that ankle turn. That's what it was. Ouch. That's actually not bad. If it's a knee, it's game after game. Again, we don't know for sure, but ankles heal a lot quicker than knees.
Corey Boyd, the sophomore out of Orange, New Jersey. Ian Summers will continue to make a lot of noise in that backfield. A couple of sophomore running backs. It'll bring up a third down and 10 now for the Gamecocks.
This is a situation where Pinkins can't make a mistake. You don't want to make a mistake. And he doesn't.
Nice route by Troy Williamson. Knew right where the first down marker was. Got an extra yard on it. And that'll move the chains after the gain of 13.
Dave Pinkins does such a nice job of sitting back there, looking at the pressure, seeing the pressure come and delivering the strike. He's got big targets out there. He's a big quarterback himself, looks downfield. I've been impressed with his play.
There is no question that Dondrell Pinkins, Dave, is the man in charge of this team. He has taken complete control. Questions about his confidence, his ability to run this team, they have all been answered to this point.
Well, absolutely. They said he was quiet in the huddle. He's not a real vocal leader, but you can lead by example. When I played with Stabler, Stabler never said a whole lot in the huddle. He just led by example. And I like to see that in a young quarterback. He doesn't have that loud voice in the huddle. Take charge. He's leading by example today.
Dondrell has had a wonderful afternoon, and now we're getting to see a little bit of what this South Carolina offense will look like, and it'll be run first, run second, maybe pass third, but they are going to grind it out, and why not? They got four guys that can carry the ball, five if you count Dondrell Pinkins, your quarterback, and six if you throw Savelle Newton in the mix. There's Dacus Terman. and they have a solid offensive line. That's the other thing about this whole offensive scheme and what you can do. If you don't have a good line, none of it means squat.
Well, it's absolutely right. Great coaches make great just kind of adjustments with their personnel. Now, Lou Holtz told us we don't have a fullback, but he's made great adjustments without that fullback. He's actually got a fullback in his quarterback because Pinkins is about 245. But he's made good adjustments. That's the sign to me of a good coach when you make those type of adjustments.
Down the right side goes Andre Gaws. Gaws breaks a couple of tackles inside the 25. Actually, they mark him out of bounds way back at the 35-yard line. But that will be enough for another South Carolina first down.
Timing play, reverse, in motion, come back. Now he makes a little dip in there, then gets back to the outside. He sees that sideline, he runs down. You run hard, you don't worry about the sideline, but he's got enough to pick up that first down. That's what counts.
End of the third quarter, South Carolina still in control.
Back at Vanderbilt Stadium in Nashville with South Carolina on top of the Commodores, 24-6 on the Gamecock sideline. You hear the applause, but it's not good news for Corey Boyd. You saw that ankle kind of buckle on the far sideline. He's going in for precautionary x-rays. They're taking a look at the right ankle, but he's done for the day, Dave.
Man, that's, you hate to see a guy like Corey Boyd go down. Let's just hope it is not serious. Savelle Newton in at quarterback, hit by Robert Denwood. Well, time to take a look at our third quarter stats, and those rushing yards pretty much tell you the whole story today. You take the rushing yards, time of possession, add it all up, and you get 24-6.
232. What'd Lou say?
He wanted 230.
He got 230. You know what's amazing? People always talk about the heat. It's not the heat that gets the linemen. It's the humidity. That's what's out there today. I remember when I played in New Orleans, that humidity used to kill us.
Look at the moves of Demetrius Summers, but Vanderbilt stays sharp. Andrew Pace from the safety makes the tackle. That's a nice tackle from Pace because Summers is a nifty, nifty runner.
He is a nifty runner, but you can't miss tackles. That is the name of the game. Got 11 missed tackles. There's one. There's two. There's going to be another one right there. You just cannot miss tackles. You got to wrap them up. You got to hold on. Grab anything you can.
It is third down and eight. It's Summer. 7.4 average. Pretty good stuff.
That's nice.
But it's third down and eight, and I think we're in two down territory. South Carolina has already missed two field goals today. Pinkins pump fakes. Has time. Now lofts it up. Well, that was all kinds of contact around the 10-yard line. Bill Alford was covering Matthew Thomas, and they were both banging each other over there about the 7 or 8-yard line.
I thought it might be Thomas putting his arms out. It looked like he was putting his arms out or something there. Okay. There's got to be an argument here. Oh, wow. Oh.
They were just flat out wrestling, yeah. Those two.
Well, there was no advantage to either one. I think I would have rather not thrown the flag. Looked like they were both involved in it. Watch the right of your screen there. You may see it on tail end. See, they're kind of bumping back in there.
All the pushing and shoving occurred before we got to that point. That's when they kind of freed up.
Wow, I didn't see it that way. But that's why we got those officials. They're a lot closer to the game.
High formation on first down now. Hard count. Ray Brown, 94, might have, a couple of guys actually for Vanderbilt might have popped up across the line of scrimmage and made some contact.
Throw the ball is snapped, dead ball. Offside on the defense, number 94. 5 yards, still first down.
Well, our Chick-fil-A nugget of today's games takes a look at the SEC's returning career leaders. David Green, of course, taking the field today against Georgia Southern. There's Carnell Williams, 2,600 yards. Brett Gibson, the leading returning career receiver. And Eric Oliver, 258 tackles as an Ole Miss safety. Here's Demetrius Summers. Demetrius has a hole, breaks some tackles inside the five, fumbles a football out of bounds. Did it go through the end zone? It will. And did it go through the end zone? I'm waiting on the call.
I see.
Will it be a touchback?
I see one official. I thought he was marking about the 4-yard line, but
ball was fumbled in and out of the end zone. By rule, it is a touchback.
Absolutely.
First down and 10.
It will be a touchback. There was no signal in the corner of that end zone. To the first turnover today by Lou Holtz's Gamecocks. Came inside the red zone. 24-6, South Carolina out in front. Fourth quarter action, but Vanderbilt picks up a big turnover, and they will start from their own 20.
Start throwing it.
Here's Quan'e Dawson. Quan'e slips a tackle, gets to the 25, maybe 26-yard line.
Dave, you start thinking about what can Vanderbilt do to get back in this game. They've got to have big plays. They've got to go downfield. They've got to find Eric Davis downfield, Brandon Smith, maybe Dunning coming off the line, but they've got to move the ball, and they've got to move it in a hurry.
Doster stays in at tailback. Cutler under center. Clock moving at 12:48.
Pressure.
Cutler steps up, fires off one leg, passes caught at the 40-yard line by Marlon White. That'll be a first down. It'll stop the clock momentarily. A gain of 14.
They bring pressure on him up the middle. You see the pressure coming in the quarterback's face. Good pickup there. And then Cutler just looks up and just throws a strike. Marlon White has his football. If he doesn't kind of crouch right there, if he just turns around, his defender had fallen down. Now, no huddle. Keep that defense out there. Make something happen. Go quick.
Ball's gone.
Cutler produces a complete pass to Eric Davis. Jonathan Joseph on the coverage. Gain of 4 on the play. Cutler last year, 21 of 23 in the second half against South Carolina in a Vanderbilt loss, but he finished with 319 yards. Those three touchdowns all came in the second half. Cutler today completed 17 of 25 passes. He'll throw it again, and this time he'll keep it. Cutler across midfield. Cutler to the 40 and runs out of bounds at the 38-and-a-half yard line of South Carolina.
Good heads-up play by Cutler. Get as many yards as you can. Get out of bounds. Stop the clock. A little bit of pressure. He's got good pocket sense right here. A little play action now. Gets the pressure and knows he's got to come up and then get to the outside. Missed tackle right there by Fred Bennett, number 8. Get as many yards as you can. Stop the clock. They're moving the football.
Movement up front. Preston Thorne, the defensive tackle, crosses the neutral zone and makes contact.
That's a free 5 yards. Free 5 yards.
Before the snap, dead ball, offside. Defense 94. 5-yard penalty.
Hey, fans, be sure to enter the Toyota You Pick 'Em contest. Just go online at jpsports.com and click on the Toyota banner. Pick the winner of each week's game and automatically register to win an all-expense-paid trip for two to the college football game of your choice, the Toyota You Pick 'Em contest. First and 5. Another hard count by Cutler. Nearly drew the Adrian Coley offsides from his defensive end position. And he'll check off. Doster moves to the right of Cutler. Play action. Cutler going for 6. Overthrows Brandon Smith. Looks like some confusion, though, in the backfield before that play got set.
I looked over just before that play, and Cutler signaled something over there. Looked across at his wide receiver. They had that good eye coordination. Just overthrew it, but that could have been 6 points and probably should have been.
No huddle for Vanderbilt. Second down and 5. Here's Smith. slipped it inside and rolls around to about the 31-yard line. Marcus Lawrence, first man to wrap him up.
Well, if you don't get the defensive line to react to this, it doesn't work. It works. But the defensive line reacts so quick that they get out there and make tackles. Good heads-up play there. Linebacker coming across. Number 46 is Lawrence. But if you don't get out there and don't get help, you're in trouble.
Jason Burns, number 13, on the field now for Vanderbilt, along with Eric Davis and Brandon Smith. Foster in the backfield. Cutler sees a seam, will run for it. He's popped at about the 29-yard line by Marcus Lawrence. That'll be very close from lunging forward, but Lawrence, the first man there.
Boy, he got stuck. He was trying to stretch, but when he got stuck, he got stuck. Marcus Lawrence and Trotcher just leveled him on the play. They didn't let him fall forward.
We will bring in the chains. Or we won't actually physically go bring in the chains. There are people down there that will do that. We will watch them bring the chains in. God forbid we do any manual labor anyway, right?
That's right. In this heat? Oh, short. What do you think?
Well, everybody in the booth seems to think it's short, and they are correct. About a yard shy, but when you're down 24-6, you've got to do something, and you've got to go for it. No turning back now.
Nope. You don't know what can happen. There's almost 11 minutes in the game. This is my favorite time.
Oh, boy. Go ahead and say it. First time.
Big man. I'm big man. I used to love this. I mean, you get down there, you're just going to see who's the best. Me against John Hanna.
Couple of tight ends in the game. Doster is your tailback. Cutler will keep it. Ball flags down in the defensive backfield.
Boy, what a surge by South Carolina. And that just lets your linebacker, Marcus Lawrence, 46, just clean up.
Well, Cutler looks like he got popped right across the bridge of the nose.
Oh, he did. Lawrence just stuck him.
Illegal participation, more than 11 players on the defense. First down.
Boy, and well, Newholtz.
That'll generally get somebody freed up.
Look at this. Now watch your linebacker. Boom! Just come right in there. They just came in. Great line surge up front. And then Marcus Lawrence comes across, except they made a mistake. Wow. And Newholtz doesn't like that. He doesn't like those mental mistakes. They haven't had many of them today, though. How about Lawrence? Maybe.
Well, that penalty, though, Dave, moves the ball inside the 15-yard line, and it's first down and 10. There's still a lot of time left, 10:27.
They may have lucked out because I don't think they were going to make it on their effort.
Play action. Cutler throws, and a big hit by Fred Bennett on Brandon Smith at about the 10. Bennett, one of these youngsters, making his first appearance in South Carolina, along with Cove Simpson in that secondary.
This is the way you want to tackle through them. Just get up, pick them up, stick them down in that ground. That's the way you play defense. Boy, that's a big-time hit. You love seeing that on Monday when you watch the films.
Bennett, the sophomore out of Manning, South Carolina, 6'2", 185, playing alongside free safety Cove Simpson. Cutler, all day to throw, lost it up looking for Doster. He gets rocked on the other side by another newcomer, the junior college transfer, Jonathan Joseph.
I want to tell you, South Carolina is playing hustle defense. When Newholtz told us they came in shape, look at the way they're flying to the football. That's misdirection. You're trying to trick them, come out of the backfield. They're not falling forward. Look at this. You run through them. You tackle through them, drive through. Look at that. Get your hands in there. Break up the football. That's just good defensive coaching.
Cutler, 18 of 27, throwing the football today for 213 yards. Look at those South Carolina coaches talking to Rick Minner, the defensive coordinator, down on the field. Cutler fires over the middle. Picked off! Jamacia Jackson! To midfield. He may go the distance. Touchdown, South Carolina, 99 yards.
Wow. Wow.
We have seen it all today.
He was going to Eric Davis on that slant, and he just came. Where did he come from? He came from midfield, read the quarterback's eyes. Cutler throws that slant. He knew he was throwing it to Davis. And look at that. Jamaison Jackson, 99 yards. That is an incredible play. But that's reading the quarterback's eyes. That's good book work, knowing the kind of plays that they like to go to. And he just read Eric Davis on that slant all the way.
Josh Brown for the point after. It is good. We talked about the newcomers in that South Carolina secondary. Well, Jamaison Jackson's a guy who's played in this league before. He read that one well. The result, 99 yards the other way. And this is interesting, Dave. They're going to give him a 98-yard interception return. I'm like, come on. Give him 99. He had a foot on the one. Anyway, regardless, it's the fourth longest interception return for a touchdown in South Carolina history. You know, last year we saw a 99 and 98-yard touchdown pass from Donjell Prinkins. One of them went to Matthew Thomas. The other went to Troy Williamson. We had both of those games on JP, and now we see the 98-yard interception return. Lou's providing us plenty of highlights. Thank you, Lou. Wobbly kick taken by Lorenzo Parker, trying to get to the outside, and he's popped at about the 17-yard line. Taki Muhammad getting down there on special teams. Well, coming up Saturday at 12:30 Eastern, 11:30 Central, Auburn takes on Mississippi State. The Tigers once again in the top 20 to begin this season. Bulldogs will open with Sylvester Croom making his SEC play debut in Starkville. Auburn and Mississippi State on JP Sports SEC Game of the Week, 12:30 Eastern. And log on to jpsports.com and click on the Regions Bank Road Trip Planner for the quickest routes and all the information you need traveling around the SEC. First and 10. Stanley Doty just stepped up, and, well, we heard the collision all the way up here.
Yes, we did.
Norval McKenzie lost about a yard.
Come off the line, slant in there, and look at that. Boy, that's a big stick. Look at the enthusiasm they've got in there. Stanley in there, just everybody patting him on the back.
Stanley, 315 pounds, just a freshman out of Louisiana.
Well, now this is a lineman's dream. You got a big lead. You can come off the ball. You can enjoy yourself. And they are 3 yards in the backfield. Dave, before, just as he's getting a handoff, as the back's getting a handoff, he's having a turn. He's bumping into people. Great penetration. That was Hurley that time. Coming through the line. Look at this. Nowhere to go. Wrap him up. Put him down on the ground. You play defense with enthusiasm and emotion. And for Bobby Johnson, it's not been any of that.
You remember Little League football when the offensive line would miss blocks and the coach would come out and say, all right, here's the deal. You, the offensive tackle, we're going to give you the ball and we're going to tell the offensive line not to block.
Don't
see
block
how you like
anybody.
It. Over the middle, wide open is Brandon Schmidt. He gets belted around, but that'll be a first down at the 35. Coe Simpson makes the tackle. Smith just found a little hole and cut it off before the defensive back wall could converge.
Cutler held in there. He saw pressure. Good crossing pattern. They've gone to that a lot. That was what the interception was on Eric Davis, was a crossing pattern where they read it well. But now if you're South Carolina, you just drop back. You don't want them to break the big one on you. Make him catch it in front of you. Come up and tackle him.
Cutler steps and fires. Taki Muhammad on the coverage on the far side of Eric Davis. It's incomplete. Take a look at our Hummer scoreboard. There's Oklahoma by 16 in the fourth quarter. Michigan Up by 33. Final, Ohio State beats Cincinnati. That's Rick Minner's old club. Iowa over Kent State in the fourth. Cal pounding Air Force now. That's late in the fourth. And Virginia over Temple. Wisconsin, 34-6 winners over Central Florida. And here it is 31-6. South Carolina with 7:15 to go in the contest.
For the snap, dead ball. Offside. Neutral zone infraction, 55 defense, 5 yards, still second down.
Well, let's go down to Dave Baker with our Altel sideline connection. And Buzz, you know, they're changing a lot of things in Columbia. One of those is the uniforms, but it's much more than that.
Yeah, that's true. Lou Holtz talked about changing the culture, Dave, but the fans back here behind the Carolina bench are talking about that black magic. These are the uniforms that they wore back in the Joe Morrison era. And Rick Minner wanted to return to that. He's returned to that kind of defense as well. First game is a new coordinator, new system. You think there might be some missteps. They've had a couple of goal line stands, and now they brought that last interception all the way back. It's been a great debut for Minner in this defense.
Well, Buzz, a high snap over Cutler's head will result in about a 10-yard loss back to the 25. The Adrian Coley will get credit for the tackle. And up front, Trey Holloway is a young man who has had to make a late switch. A defensive lineman, Vanderbilt, had issues at center. Lost a player to a Mormon mission. Lost another player to academics. So they moved Trey Holloway from defensive line over to center just about a month ago, right as preseason practice began. The coaches said they're really happy with the way he has progressed and learned that position, because it is not easy in this league.
Boy, it is really tough to make that snap and get that first step where you can reach and get a tackle or a linebacker.
Another high snap. Cutler off his back foot. Lost it up in the air. Davis broke off his route, and that'll bring up a fourth down situation. Fourth and 18. Today's closed captioning brought to you by Nissan and your Nissan dealer. .621 to go, and Vanderbilt will have to punt it away. Noah Whiteside dancing around to the 40-yard line, and that's where the Gamecocks will take over. And I think we'll begin to see some of those second teamers come on the field for South Carolina. 6:10 to go in the fourth quarter. High formation for South Carolina as Savelle Newton is in at quarterback as handoff goes to Dacus Terman. Also getting a first look at Jamie Peters, who is playing some fullback. They actually just moved him from defensive end to put a body over there that might be able to block and pick up a couple of yards out of the backfield. Sophomore out of Trenton, South Carolina. 31-6, Dave.
I know. Oh, I'm telling you, I'm really impressed. I'm impressed with South Carolina's condition, too. They have bounced around today. I know they've controlled the line of scrimmage, and that helps. But they have bounced. They are really in good condition.
Newton will throw for the first time today. Maybe he won't, because he's brought down in the backfield by Ray Brown and Greg Jacobs on the sack. You know, if you're Bobby Johnson, Dave, you know, he grew up in the state of South Carolina, went to Eau Claire High School and spent time in Columbia as a kid going to South Carolina games. There's got to be, you know, a special bit of him. He went to Clemson, however.
Yeah.
That's where he played. So he's familiar with South Carolina and their fans and their fans' loyalty and stuff. But you know that he really, really, really wanted to win this football game because he felt his team had a chance to do something special this year. And they still do have that chance.
Yeah, their first 5 weeks were, they were pointing at their first 5 weeks thinking, hey, if we can get by South Carolina. I don't think that they even thought South Carolina was nearly this good. I think South Carolina's got just a lot of weapons out there. They've run the ball. They've controlled it on the line of scrimmage. Their line has played well. They haven't made the mental mistakes that you think that could turn a football game. See? Boy, Dave, when you talk about running, golly, South Carolina didn't have a fullback. I mean, they have flat out run by committee. Look at that. See the number of runners. And you can add Newton in there, the other quarterback, so that makes eight people today that have carried the football.
Well, punting now for South Carolina. Josh Brown to handle the punting. Haven't seen much of the South Carolina punting team today. Eric Davis with a fair catch. Lou Holtz has to be quite pleased with today's outcome. You know, we mentioned Bobby Johnson growing up in South Carolina. We'll finish that story when we come back. Johnson, moments ago, growing up in Columbia area, one of his favorite players was Alex Hawkins, great wide receiver. Went on to win a Super Bowl with the Colts, play with the Falcons a little bit. Pass is caught on the far side, just shy of the first down. And Alex Hawkins, by the way, living in Denmark, South Carolina, has written a new book called Cooking with Cocky. He and his wife, Charlie, kind of put together some great stories and some recipes, and that's just, he's a piece of work. South Carolina fans know all about Alex Hawkins.
He's one of them old school players. Yeah, he called me, left a message. I ain't talked to you in years. I said, you're right.
Here's the handoff to Quanay Doster. Quanay breaks a couple of tackles and picks up the first down. The announcers for this game are selected and compensated by Jefferson Pilot Sports. This broadcast is a copyright presentation. Any use of this broadcast without the express permission of the Southeastern Conference and Jefferson Pilot Sports is prohibited. I'd like to say goodbye to one of our good buddies, a guy that I have worked with since I became part of the JP family about 7 years ago. It was Todd Minhinnan, produces our pregame show and does a lot more than that. He is heading up, staying in Charlotte. We're going to head up the Charlotte Bobcats television package, the new NBA team. We certainly wish him the best in his future endeavors. We'll miss him here at JP Sports.
Absolutely. Brought a lot of passion to this game. All those opening things Yeah, look at him. He's doing a lot of work right now. He's just standing on the sideline. Gosh.
See, he's already getting that NBA goatee working for him, too. Yeah. Oh, Todd, also a proud new papa a few months ago. So certainly things are good for Todd, and we'll miss him. So he's been a big part of this, and what you see on the air, a lot of it has to do with that young man.
Absolutely.
All right, that's enough of the love for Todd, I think, today.
Oh, no, where's the love?
He gave an emotional speech today before the game, didn't he?
Yes, he did. I want to tell you something. He just about cried, and I understand why.
Cutler dropped at the 38-yard line. Time for our Hummer scoreboard and some late games getting underway. Auburn leading Louisiana Monroe 17-0. Georgia Tech all over Samford in their opener. William and Mary up by 10 in the third quarter. So, Dave, Bobby Johnson, where does he go from here? I mean, there were expectations for Vanderbilt. Let's face it, there was talk of bowl games, and he said he wasn't going to downplay those expectations to his club. But, I mean, this has got to hurt a little bit.
Well, they've got a week off, and then they come back. They need to regroup. They've got to get things going. They can't be controlled on the line of scrimmage like they were today.
Cutler with a bullet. Caught in South Carolina territory by Brandon Smith. That'll be a first down.
Hey, you know, we have a lot of fans down there in Florida, and our thoughts certainly go out to them as they prepare for this hurricane.
And, you know, speaking of that, we talked to Lou Holtz about that. His house, when Hurricane Charlie came through and hit Orlando, his house, his wife Beth lives down there most of the year, and she was at home, and Hurricane Charlie did some serious damage to his house. Lou was at practice in Columbia, actually drove down after practice, stayed the night to make sure Beth was okay. As the bomb to the end zone is picked off in the end zone. Looks like Jermaine Harris comes away with the INT, the second today. And that'll give it back to South Carolina. Cutler just threw it up, hoping that maybe something good would happen. And Harris comes away with the interception. South Carolina will get it at the 20 with 1:46, and they are in complete control. 31-6. Jermaine Harris, junior out of Tyrone, Georgia, with the interception moments ago, giving the ball back to South Carolina. Oh, Mitchell in at quarterback. Little toss to Andre Goss.
Well, Dave, if I'm South Carolina, I've got to be happy with one thing, and that's my defense, that Rick Minter defense. A lot of movement along the line. Get penetration in the backfield. When you need it, step up. See right there, that's the step up. 98 yards. As Jamaica Jackson takes that ball all the way back. They played very, very solid defense. I think quite a credit to Rick Minter and his staff.
Change at quarterback as Mike Rath comes in for that snap. The quarterback draw out to the 35. Clock moves. 62 seconds to go. I'll tell you what, South Carolina has Georgia next week. Huge yep. game for the Gamecocks in Columbia. The place will be packed to the rafters. You know that. And I got to tell you, you know, Georgia's expected to do some great things this year, but from what I've seen today with a good defense and the ability to run the football, South Carolina has a chance to really hang with those guys, especially at home. Our Napa players of the game today. Dontrell Pinkins, 245 all-purpose yards, a couple of TDs. There's Brandon Smith, six catches for 71 yards for Vanderbilt. Napa players of the game.
I know your big question, can they hang with Georgia next week? You know, if I had 80-some thousand fans there and I had this football team, I'd like to believe I could. I think they're going to surprise people this year. I think they're that good a football team.
The South Carolina fans, it looks like whatever Lou Holtz did over the summer certainly works. Lou Holtz goes to 12-2 all time. Against this Vanderbilt team, meets with Bobby Johnson at the center of the field. 31-6, South Carolina wins it. Guess what? They sit atop the SEC East standings. We'll come back and have a final thought when we return.
Crystal Mojo?
Mojo is a little something that makes you feel like you got it.
Makes us more hot.
Yeah, hot and spicy.
Jumbo Spicy Wing Mojo.
Spice just, you know, penetrates your whole system.
We'll give you mojo. It's all meat, and they're still ginormous.
They're off the scale.
They're jumbo. They're spicy. They're perfect for in the car.
Mojo. Yes. Good word.
You gotta give them attitude.
Mojo. Big taste.
You want the toughest ATV? You want the best price ever? And you want payments under $50 a month? Not a problem. Announcing the Polaris Factory Authorized Clearance Sale. Save up to $700 on any new 2004 Polaris ATV, including the Sportsman 700 Twin. And get $49 a month payments. You want the toughest ATV? Get to your Polaris ATV dealer now. Offer ends September 30th.
SEC football has been brought to you by Napa Auto Care Center, by Chick-fil-A, by Hyundai, by Surplus Warehouse, by Bell South, by the Polaris ATV, by Crystal, and by Hummer.
South Carolina goes to 1-0. Vanderbilt 0-1 as we start the 2004 season. We'll return to Nashville after a word from your local stations.
Mann Tool & Supply has been in business almost 60 years, offering competitive prices for your heavy-duty or hobby projects. If you're looking for tools that get the job done right, Mann has the brands you trust, like DeWalt, Delta, Jet, Bosch, Makita, Porter Cable, and Milwaukee. Experience what sets them apart from big store chains, like their on-site factory-authorized repair center, a fully stocked media room, and their demonstration room. Visit South Carolina's largest independently-owned tool store today. Mann Tool & Supply. Superior service before and after the sale.
At the Dodge Labor Day clearance, things are moving fast. During Labor Day weekend, get huge deals on the best selection of the remaining 2004 Dodges. Grab the tough Dodge Ram 1500 quad cab with 0% financing plus $2,500 in bonus cash for a total savings of up to $8,100. Or grab huge cash allowances on the rugged Dakota or the roomy Durango, plus our 770 powertrain limited warranty. So hurry in for the best selection of 04s during the Dodge Labor Day clearance. Hit it!
It's over between us. There's no connection, just mixed signals. I'd want to watch a movie, but you'd go out almost every night. I mean, you're not even working right now. I'm leaving you for Time Warner Digital Cable. They have much more to offer. They're even paying me $300 to dump you.
Time Warner Digital Cable. A relationship you can count on.
You're not a man.
South Carolina faces Georgia next week, and they got to feel pretty confident with their victory today here on the road to open up the 2004 SEC season. 31-6, the final score. So for Dave Baker, Dave Rowe, Rob Reichle, Gary Klem, Todd Manhattan, and the rest of our crew, I'm Dave Neal saying so long, everybody. We'll see you next week from Starkville, 12:30 Eastern time. You've been watching Jefferson Pilot Sports exclusive coverage of Southeastern Conference football.
It's Dodgeland's 84-hour Super Clearance Sell-a-thon.
You've waited all year for the best deals. Now you win. JT.
Dodgeland will stay open 84 hours straight to sell 84 vehicles regardless of profit or loss.
Caravan saved $6,000.
No, $9,000.
Ram saved $7,000.
No, $11,000.
Durango saved $8,000.
No, $12,000. Super save at Dodgeland's 84-hour.